Welcome to this B1 Printer Delivery e-learning session, where we'll be looking into custom reporting. So let's go into Business 1 and see what that is about. So here we are in Business 1, and custom reporting is, just for disclaimer, the most advanced things you can do in B1 Printer Delivery. Because what it can do, as the name says custom, is that you can make reporting on stuff that is not out of the box for print and delivery. So meaning, if we look at the wizard, these are the different things we can do out of the box. But if you want to do something on a screen that is not listed here, or on an add-on screen, if it follows certain rules that we'll go into, you can use custom reporting to essentially make your own checkbox like this. So our scenario in this case, in order to do this, is that we are taking B1 usability packets recurring invoice system, meaning this screen here, which is essentially a tool to do recurring invoices instead of with these templates. The scenario, which I will go end to end here, I haven't prepared anything other than a crystal report, so you can see every single little detail of how this is set up. But our customer scenario is that you have a customer who have a lot of these invoice templates, and they are asking you, hey, could we make a system that once a month sent to the invoice template person who is receiving it, so in this case Star Company, in this one Parameter Technologies, send how the invoice template is, so they can verify that they want to run it for the next period again, or if they have any changes to it. And out of the box, invoice templates here cannot really do anything with Print Delivery. It's not a common scenario, but for this specific customer it is. But if you go up here and you try to do something with print, you will see you can only end up with a screenshot like this. You could technically send that to the customer, but we want to have it more professional and want to have it automated in the system. So that is the setup, and what we need, of course, is to set up Print Delivery, but in order to send something, we need a crystal report. And that is the only thing I've prepared in front here. So here is the crystal report for this. It's just some very simple data from the header, which is this table, and from the lines, which is this table. And we are asking for a specific ID. So we could, for example, ask for the third one, which is for Star Company, and we will see what's in there. So nothing out of the ordinary of crystal reports, only one parameter in, which in this case we call the doc key. And that is essentially the setup. Now we will go step by step into what is needed in order for us to be able to go to the screen, print here, go to the mass delivery and print out the multiple of them, and finally set up the schedule in the end, so everything is automated as our customers wish for. In order to do that, we have various steps we need to do. Let's start by the crystal report, so we have that on hand, in that we will go to the print and delivery section here and make a new crystal report definition. So we will call it recurring invoice, and we will make it file based and find the crystal report, which is this one. So now we have it in here, and we're just calling it doc key as normal. So we save that, and we have the recurring invoice in place to move on. So next step is that we need to make the report actions, the report configurations, and so on. But before we can do that, we need to do some mass delivery. Because In order to do this, if we just went in here into Printer Delivery and went to the report configuration, there is no type here that is called recurring invoices. So we couldn't finish this. We could write a description, we could choose the crystal report that we just made for recurring invoices. We could make the different report actions, but we couldn't choose anything here, so we couldn't end the configuration. So for that, we need a custom. And the first time you make a custom, it will say there is no mass delivery of custom, so we want to make one. I could press yes, and we will open up the mass delivery configuration, or I could have gone to the mass delivery configuration from here as well, up here. Because in here we have the various mass delivery configurations for the various different type of objects that was out of the box. And we need to make one more of these so it is quotation out of the box. So let's call it recurring invoice. And let me open one so we can see the comparison of, for example, the sales order, where we can in sales order go in and write a where condition. We get the predefined SQL, and we have a few extra options, but nothing fancy here. When we go to what do we call custom, which is down here, it's a bit more information we need to give before we can actually do something. Because whenever we do something for sales order, we, Boyum, already know what on a sales order, where is the customer's code, what is the primary key, what is the contact person ID, and such things. When it's custom, you essentially need to tell us, because if you don't tell us, we have no way of knowing. So what we need to do is we need to write a SQL statement first. And we need to write a SQL statement that gives us the data from the recurring invoice. And let's have a look down in recurring invoice what that table is. So in here we have the docnum. In our case, docnum and docentry are the same, so we could do either or, but let's just take the docnum as that's the one we're seeing here. And we can see it comes from a table called BOY abon. So let me bring up a SQL Management Studio so we can make a few SQLs and then take it from there. So select star from BOY abon. That is our header table, and we can see various different fields here that we need to get and represent in our system. Again, in order to tell the system where is the code, where is the contact, and so on. So the first thing we need to do is to have the docnum. And that is just here. Again, docnum and docentry will always be the same for invoice template. So it is what we can choose either or in this case. Doesn't really matter. The second thing we need to have is, in our case, what is, so let me start in a different way. In order for us to tell, we need to write the SQL, and then we need to tell what is what in that SQL. So the table, we can actually take that already, is the BOY abon, meaning we need to tell what table is the primary table of this system. The second one is the doc key, meaning the primary key. That would be the docnum or docentry. Doesn't matter in this case. Then we would need in the SQL a BP code. And we need the BP code in order for us to find things like a default contact person, main email. So we need it to email. Else we don't really need it. If you just want to print and stuff, we don't need to put something in here. But because we want to email, we need to put it in. So let's have a look in the SQL here to see what that field is. And the names of this table is unfortunately a little odd because they have some odd names, but we can essentially see that the BP code is in a field called U underscore BOY underscore FP. So that is the field we need to put in the master library in order to know where that is. And then we also need, if we want to send to a specific contact person, we need that field as well here. So if we take a select star again here, we will be able to see that that is, see if we can find the field, or as a tip, we can just go up here, put on the system information and simply right click the field. So we can see it's this one called BOYCONT. So let's put it in there and let's put it in the SQL as well. The final thing is a language ID, and we don't really have a language. It's not like this can run in multiple languages as such. So in our case, we will just have a look here to see what language do we want to send it in, and we want to send it in English, so it needs to have the value 3. And we'll put that over here. Because what I've just filled in, and let's take the SQL, by the way, because we need to put that into the system as well. Whoops, wrong link there. There we go. So now we have sent it told, whenever you run this SQL, the table is this, the doc key is this, the BP code is this, and so on. And by giving us that, we can begin to send emails. We can begin to form the SQL that is needed in order to send the doc key to the Crystal report and so on. And that is needed whenever we need to do it off screen, meaning either with mass delivery or with a scheduler. If we need to do it using the GUI, meaning if we should be able to stand here and press the email button, we need to give the UI version of all this data. So we need a form type. Well, we can simply just right click here and get the form type of the invoice template. We can also go in and get the doc key, which is up here, meaning that is this dynamic syntax. And again, these buttons over here will tell you what it is it requires. The PP code is this field. So we'll put that in here. And the contact code is this field. Again, not everything is needed. If you don't have a contact code, doesn't matter. But then, of course, you can't send to the to that specific document's contact. So let's add this. And now we have a recurring invoice. But we are not using it anywhere, and that was where we came from, that we wanted to use it here and we didn't have any. But now if I go back and forward here, we actually have the recurring invoice, so we can begin to build this up. So we have the recurring invoice, we had our crystal, and to make it just so we can see that everything is working, let's start by just taking the print preview and just take the normal show report. Because if we do this and we open up our recurring invoice template, this should actually be enough to be able to execute this button and see our recurring invoice, which is nice. So we are up and running here in the system, and we can now add even more things to it. But if you just want to be able to show and print, now would be enough data for us to do. But we want to email, and especially email later on with mass delivery and stuff, because right now, if we went to mass delivery and chose our recurring invoice, the only option we would have would be print preview, because that's the only one we've given here. So we would be able to run this, and whatever you put in here is what you see in here. Technically, you only need to put in the doc key. We can provide the rest, but in order for you to put in more information so it's easier to use in a mass delivery, put some more in here if you want to. In that case, I could take all three and get three versions of the preview. Let me close the other ones as well. But we want to email, so let's go into email settings and let's go in and make a new one, because none of the other ones will fit this system. So, recurring invoices. And let's take email report, subject, and I will write them with hard-coded things here first, and then we'll see a little later on how we can use keywords in here as well. Here is your template. Please let us know if you have any changes for the next month. Like this. We will just call it template.pdf, and then later on again make this one. We will add a to email, and in our case, because we have default contact person, that should be possible to use. But we could use all the other ones. A header would have worked if we only had the BP code, but because we also have the contact person, that would work. Default, these two would work only with card code. This one that begins to work because we have the contact. Email categories would have worked as well, and direct email would also, of course, have worked. So it's only this one that needs the contact code. But every one of them needs to have the business partner code before they work. But let's put it like this. And for now, let's just use Outlook and try out the system. So again, let's go into invoice template and press the email button. And now email button will also work. And if we see my Outlook here, we can see the draft. And we can see recurring invoice, here's your template and stuff. But we might want to have use some of the data from the thing. We can see the template, by the way, is the right one, so that's okay. But if we wanted, for example, to say it was number two here or whatever we want in here, we need to actually change a bit in terms of using the dynamic syntax. So let's jump into the email button. And in normal cases, you would just be able to simply take the value here and put in up here. But if we do that right now, what you will see is, yes, it's working. But if we used mass delivery instead, let's take the recurring invoices and email and send out number two again. It will not know what this is about. And this one is a small mistake on my side, because essentially what I just need to do is I need to quickly remember the square brackets here. That is the reason that failed. So let's try again and see now that we got a recurring invoice from the mass delivery, but it went in and had a zero here, And the reason for that is the system right now as a GUI knows what the boy33.number is, so this item is boy33 in the system, but it has no clue when it comes to not having that screen open when we run mass delivery or schedules when we come to that. So for that reason, there's a system whenever you do a custom delivery like this on a screen that you can simply right click on them. Printer delivery will be here now, and there's something called map form for dynamic syntax. That means that it will begin to understand that boy underscore 33 means doc num, boy 38 here means this field, and so on. So we need to map it. And prior to version 2022.05, you needed to restart Business One after that because there was some caching issues. In 2022.05 or later, it actually fixed it automatically. So if I run this again and take number two, you will see that now we don't get the zero, we actually get the real value in here. And we could begin to use the various other things, like, for example, the invoice day. So we could take that field and say your invoice day is, and then the number in here. And when we emailed, it would understand that and show a one. So if you want to use the dynamic syntax again, for example, also if you wanted the template number down here in here, you would need to do that mapping or use the table syntax, which would actually work out of the box. But remember in here and then map, so we have given us the information about the screen. And a little about this as well in general is that if you're doing this on an SAP screen, it will mostly likely work. But fields need to be bound directly to database fields for this to work. So if you have a calculated field, we wouldn't magically be able to redo that calculation. Or if your add-on is not following the rules of data binding and didn't have the values for table name and field name, it would not work. In this case, we are, because this is essentially a UDO, which is also something you could hook this up to. So that is just some limitations of this. So the final thing we need to do is set up the scheduling part. And for that, we need to quickly go to this setting and have a server delivery method as well. Right now, I don't see I have any, so I'll just quickly put one in. I'll just pause the video here, put it in, I have it in my system. One second. So to the matter of editing, you can see I've now put in my SMTP. I've tested it just a second ago, and since this is going to the right one, I'm showing a web version now of my email instead, but it sent out a test mail. So we have separate e-learnings on the SMTP part. But if I hadn't put this in, the scheduling part would not have worked. So I will put this in now, and we will have a full setup now where we can now go in and build the final piece of the puzzle here, which is the printer delivery schedule. And the schedule is that easy to do. So recurring invoice, and we need to take the recurring invoice here. We want to email. I need an error email, should something go wrong. And I want to set the schedule to be a monthly one. And I want to send on the 20th of each month at 10 o'clock. I want to send out this so the customer have 10 days to come back with their that changes until we run it again on the first. So I'll put that in. And if I go to the server component, we can now see that schedule which we have here. The only thing I want to do right now is, if I were to send it now, it would essentially send to Daniel Brown and all the other test people here. And then we wouldn't be able to see the real emails because they would go to non-existing email addresses. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to put in a direct email here directly to me, just as for demo purposes, so we can actually see what's going on here. So I'll put that in. I will have the schedule, and I will have this run. So we don't want to wait until the 20th of the month. That would be in 15 days, or almost a month from now. So I will just run here, and then we will see the emails in my Outlook. So the mails has now been sent, and are slowly going into my Outlook here, where we can see the various ones with the template 1, template 2, template 3, and the mail is our crystal report. So now we have a fully set up system with the customer that we can automatically send out these schedules, and it came from absolutely nothing. So let's summarize a bit here in that in order to do it from a screen, we need to know more about that screen. That is done with the mass delivery, where we need to write the SQL, and we need to provide the extra information at the minimum, the table and the doc key, the BP code if we want to send emails, and the contact code if we want to send to the selected contact code here. We need to do that DI-wise, or database-wise, in order to work in mass delivery and schedules, while if we just wanted to have be working on the screen, we need to put it in with UI. Then, if we want in our system over here, we need to have a crystal report. That was that simple, and the doc key here is the one you presented in the mass delivery. Crystal is like any other crystal, so there's nothing special there. If you just wanted to print or print preview, they work out of the box, while the report action, of course, needs to have sometimes the dynamic syntax, which you need to remember to map here. Once that is done, everything works exactly like the out-of-the-box systems in a normal schedule mass delivery screen setup. So the only thing is the extra work that is to explain to us all the things that we have normally not for mapped for all the system fields. But now you can essentially do it for every single screen with every single thing, as long as it's data bound in its screens. So that is everything there is to know about custom reporting. Difficult or more advanced than just the out of the box, but very, very powerful that you can even take another add-ons window and turn Printer Delivery to work directly on it, even down to the schedule level. So for that, thank you for attending the session. See you in the next one.